We've been out scouting some alfalfa. This is about 2 foot tall. It is ready to cut, but we're seeing some evidence of alfalfa weevils both in the sweep nets, and also we're seeing some damage on the tips. There's another way to make an assessment of alfalfa weevil populations besides the sweep net, and that's using stem counts, and I'll show you how that works. What you need is a bucket, white or a light colored bucket works real well. You want to look at the alfalfa field, look at the topography, try to find different types of elevation and alfalfa growth in the field. And as you go through an area, do this in 5 spots. You can either cut them off, or if you're real quick like I am, you can snap them off at the base. Put them, grab 10 stems, put them face down in a bucket. The alfalfa weevils like to be up on the tips, particularly if there's some leaves folded up towards the buds. And all you got to do is take these stems, beat them pretty hard against a bucket, and then we're going to look at how many weevils fell off of those 10 stems. I'm counting 12 weevil larvae in this bucket, and we've got 10 stems, so 12 divided by 10 is 1.2 weevils per stem, and we can use that to make an economic threshold calculation. Take 4 more 10 stem samples in the field, and that'll give you a pretty good average for the alfalfa weevil populations. Don't sample all these right along the edge. A lot of times those populations will be higher. You want an average of the field. There's some keys for identifying alfalfa weevil larvae. First off, they're legless. Makes them different than butterfly or moth caterpillars. In fact, most other larvae you're going to find out in alfalfa. They look a little grub-like. They'll often curl into a C when they're disturbed. The larger larvae are bright green. They have a distinctive white stripe down the back. It does not have a border of pink or red. Another key feature is that dark black head. As they get close to molting, that head becomes a little lighter in color, more towards a dark brown. The smaller larvae are yellowish green instead of being the bright green, and that stripe on the back is not distinctive or present in the earliest stages.